Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today, I'm talking about the butt lift video we did a few months ago using the PDO threads. And we had a lot of questions. It was a fast video to music. And a lot of people asked whether I could slow down and explain exactly what we did in the procedure. We did this with just threads. We did three per side. I'll show you the procedure and explain it in more detail. However, a lot of patients, we address a couple things. One, we do PDO threads, but we also then do Sculptra in the high buttock region to create some lift and also use it for cellulite reduction along with the thread. So most people get that combination. They like to dress both at one time because you can get a little bit of bruising. So there's a little bit of body downtime in that respect. So I'll explain that video to you in more detail. If you have further questions, you can certainly ask us below the video here. Let's go watch it now. Okay, here's, so we're marking the patient out, and I think this is really useful. Sometimes you can use a diagonal vector, either right to left or left to right, depending on what you're trying to achieve and where you're trying to lift. Here I'm using some lidocaine with epi. Now, we're using an 18-gauge needle to put these in place. We now have new 4-inch 19-gauge barbs, which work amazing. Here we're using the 21-gauge 3.5-inch barbs that we had initially. And so we still use an 18-gauge hole for both of them, but I think a little lidocaine with epi is nice here. And you can see the blanching. Now the most important thing here, this is a one-way street. You don't pull back on the cannula or you'll engage the thread early. Keep the same plane all the way through. It's just key. You can see there's slight little bit of puckering there. That means I'm just below the dermis into the fat layer, but not too deep or you won't get pull. This is key. You really have to push up to engage the end of the thread. And then we did a little twist and pulled it out. These are key little things that are, maybe you can't see necessarily from the video, but that's why we do the trainings, because without those key little efforts at the end, you won't get the same type of results. Now the threads are hanging out. The new 19-gauge 4-inch, there's not a lot of thread at the end, so you have to be mindful. But here, we're snipping the end of the sutures. Now, you can see I'm pushing down with the scissors, but you don't, of course, want to pierce the skin. And then it buries the suture, and we'll massage at the end. But this is a key little point as well, because you want to bury the suture when you let go. And so the sutures will now be gone. We do a slight little massage sideways to upward to make sure they're buried. And then I just wanted to show you real quickly a little video of some Sculptra in the buttock area. Everyone was going to ask, so I put this in. This is a different patient, of course, but I wanted to show what we're doing with Sculptra. And in this case, we're adding it to the upper pole, which is very common. We use quite a bit of fluid, quite a bit of Sculptra, of course, so you want to use a larger syringe, and you're just creating a nice projection. So that's a little bit more on exactly how we do the procedure. Combination procedures always work best, and different people do different amounts of volume and numbers of threads. If you have further questions, ask us on this YouTube channel, join us here, or on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.